Hello again. This is the second video in our Kaltura training series. In this video, I'll be discussing the processes surrounding uploading and sharing content through MediaSpace. And to begin, we're going to take a look at our Add New drop-down menu in the top right and some of the options within that. So if you haven't already, go back and watch our first video where we discuss logging into Kaltura and MediaSpace and a brief overview, and then you'll have a better idea of how we navigate through these menus. Again, I'm on the home page. I'm looking at the top right menu called Add New. Through this menu, it's how we upload most of our content into MediaSpace. Now, if we click on the Add New drop-down menu, you're going to see a list of four options. The first one here is Media Upload. Here, we can select files directly from our computer and upload them to MediaSpace. It'll prompt a file browser where we can navigate to the specific file and choose to upload it. It's important to note that transcoding is done in the cloud automatically, and media may appear after it's done being processed. Depending on the file size and data rate, this may take anywhere from a minute to several. Also, all media uploaded and captured through MediaSpace will appear under My Media in our User drop-down menu. We'll cover this in a little bit. After we've clicked on Media Upload and navigated to the file we'd like to upload to MediaSpace, it's going to ask us a couple of required metadata information that we need to fill out about the file before we can save it to My Media. At the top of the Upload Media screen, you'll see a progress bar. This will tell us a percentage of how much of the data has already been uploaded of our file. It'll also prompt you when the upload is complete. MediaSpace has tons of codec and formats it's compatible with, so you'll be hard-pressed to find a media file that it won't accept. Below the progress bar, you're going to see these metadata fields that are required to fill out before saving your media to MediaSpace. The first field here is the name of your item. By default, it'll simply just choose the file name itself, but you can put whatever designation you choose. Below the title is a description of your media piece, where you can fill out other information about what the viewer is looking at. Below description is a tags field. Tags are extremely useful, especially when users are using the search function on MediaSpace. Common tags would be, who is the subject in the media, what is the media about, where was it captured, so on and so forth. It's very similar to YouTube's tags. Finally, we have our publishing options. These are important. Our first one here is private. By default, the media will be set to private. When the media has private ownership, only you, the author, are allowed to view and edit the information. Even if you send the link to other users, they will not be able to view and they will not be able to access the file. The next option is unlisted. If the media is unlisted, it will only be visible to those who have the link. People simply navigating through MediaSpace won't be able to stumble upon this type of media. However, if you choose to embed the media and it's still unlisted, people will be able to view it on other sites. Published is our last option, and this means anyone who's authenticated through MediaSpace and Rutgers, essentially anyone who logs in, will be able to find this media. There's also a couple things to note here. You're going to have to fill out all of these fields required in order to publish the media. That's the name, the description, and tags. Also, when you're choosing what type of sharing is enabled, published may not be an option until the media is completely uploaded to MediaSpace. So if you want to publish your media right away after it's uploaded and it's not allowing you to do so, just give it a few minutes, revisit the My Media page, and then enable full publication. After our media is uploaded and we filled out all the proper metadata, including our sharing and publication options, then we're going to want to go ahead and click Save. Depending on your browser, you may see a small loading icon after clicking Save. We can also make sure that the media is successfully uploaded by going to the My Media page. We can do so by clicking on the shortcut below the File Upload menu, or we can go up to the top under our Username drop-down menu and click My Media. The My Media page is a personal media collection of your uploads and files. Here we can publish files to certain galleries or channels in addition to editing them. Also note that the larger the file, you may not see it here directly after uploading, even after a successful upload. The file has to be brought through the cloud, transcoded, and then put back on MediaSpace. So don't panic if you don't see your file right away. Try refreshing the page and coming back in a minute. Let's discuss some of the options on the My Media page itself. Up at the top, we have a bunch of filters in which we can list and sort the media. Sort by most recent, view all statuses, view all media, and media I own. These options help filter the media if you have a rather large library. There's also a search bar within My Media, which is finite to just the media you're the author of. You'll notice to the right of these filters, there's a refresh icon. This helps in case you've just uploaded a file and it has not yet appeared in My Media. You can click on this tab and momentarily it should appear. To the right of that is an Actions drop-down menu. If we select any of the boxes next to our media files, we can then choose an option from the Actions drop-down menu, such as publishing and adding it to a playlist. You'll notice in the body of the My Media page is all of our media files listed, complete with a thumbnail, their title and metadata, view and comment count, as well as when they were uploaded. And to the right, there's options for editing and deleting. Now let's look at some of the editing options for our media here. Let's go ahead and click on the Edit tab on any of our files that we've uploaded. On the Edit page for our piece of media, we're going to find a ton of tabs below the video player with options for editing and modifying our video. The first tab here is the Details tab. Here we can change any of the required parameters we were first asked to fill out when we uploaded our file. That includes the name, description, and tags. The next tab is called Collaboration. Here we can add co-editors and co-publishers to the media. This will give them authorship access. So if I wanted to give someone the same permissions as me, or to be a co-publisher, I would add them here. The third tab is the Options tab. Here we have options for clipping, which enables anyone to create clips from this piece of media, and also comment options, where we can disable comments for the media or close the discussion, not allowing any new comments. It's also important to note that if the comment section is open and users have commented on the media file, and then you disable the comments, if at any point in the future you re-enable the comments, those previous posts will reappear again. The fourth tab is the caption tab. Here is where we're allowed to upload caption file types such as SRT or DFXP formats. The fifth tab is an attachment tab. This is useful. We can upload other specific files such as PowerPoint slides, Word documents, PDFs, and so on that correspond with our media file so others may download the content while they're accessing our media file. So for instance, if you're giving a PowerPoint presentation and you'd like the users to also download the slides, you can put the PDF or image files here. The next tab is the Downloads tab. Here, we're able to choose specific formats in which the viewer can download our content. If I click any of these boxes, the user watching will have the option to download the file. You can choose original file, which will be the same resolution and data rate as which it was uploaded, a medium or small file type, which are both H.264 or MP4 conversions at slightly different data rates. The next tab is the 3Play tab. This is a service that does captioning. I would ask users to ignore this option for now, as we're working on a partnership with 3Play in the future, and right now, this functionality isn't quite developed. The next tab is the Thumbnails tab. Here we can customize the thumbnail for the media file. We have three options in which we can select a thumbnail. The first option is uploading a thumbnail from your computer. This could be as simple as an image file. The next is capturing a thumbnail from your existing media. You can use the above player to seek to the specific frame you would like to use as your default thumbnail, and then click on the capture button. The last option is an auto-generate function. MediaSpace will auto-generate several stills from your media file, and you'll simply select one of the auto-generated ones. The next tab is the timeline tab. Here, users are allowed functionality to add slides and chapter markers throughout their file. We're going to cover this function in a later video, as well as trimming and creating clip options. Our second to last option is the replace video. Here we can choose a file to upload that will replace our pre-existing file, but it will not damage any file paths, links, or embed options you've used prior. So if you're updating your content and you want all the locations to be the same, this would be your best option. Finally, we have a trim video option. I'm going to be discussing this, as well as the timeline and creating clip options in a later video. Now I'm going to go over the processes in which it's easiest to share our content to media we've uploaded to MediaSpace. From our edit page, we can click on the media's title, which will redirect us back to that media's page. Or from the My Media section, we can simply click on any thumbnail of a media item to go to its page. Once we're on any media page, you'll see beneath the title and the player is a Share tab. If we click on that Share tab, it's going to bring up two sub-options for us. The first option here is a link to the media page, and it provides for you a simple shortcut to copy and paste the URL. The second option is Embed. We have a couple options in which an embed code can be generated. You'll see beneath the Embed tab is the embed code. Here we can copy and paste and put it into any additional plugins or browsers we choose, and we can also customize the player skin by clicking on any of the three selections below and the player size. This will also modify the code to give the specific customization that we want for our player and player size. Also, it's very important to remember what our publish options were and what we have selected. If we chose private for our media, we will not be able to share the URL or embed the media anywhere. Viewers will not have access to it. If we chose private, we will be able to share the link and we will be able to embed it on other sites. But if we send the link, users may have to authenticate through the CAS just to view the media. So it's important to remember if we're sharing our media through links and external websites by embedding it, we may want to just go ahead and fully publish our media item. That way, there's no restrictions and we don't have to go back and change anything. This concludes our second lesson, how we upload media files and share them through MediaSpace. In the next lesson, I'll be going over webcam recording, how we use capture space, and screen recording through MediaSpace.